Dear friends and followers, welcome back to my channel. Today, we're going to be answering one of the most asked passenger questions: can a passenger land a plane? So Carolin is going to be performing the flight today. So Carolin, tell us a little something about you.
Well, I'm definitely not a pilot.
Okay, so let's do this.
1383, runway 27, clear to take off. United 1538, number 327.
Carolin, my name is Joe. I'll be your ATC controller today, and I'll be guiding you downwards to Munich Airport. This is the closest airport in the vicinity with the longest runway.
Okay.
The first thing we need to be doing is, well, I need to set you up for the approach phase for the flight, because at the moment you're in a holding overhead mic, so you're fine. You're in 10,000 feet. As I see from your flight plan, you have enough fuel. Now, you used the MCDU panel, and there's a button that says PERF for performance. So please press that.
Again, the one where I had the numbers, right? Yeah, okay, yes, I found it. Yes?
Okay, what does it say in the top line now?
DES.
Okay, you're in the descent phase. Now, there's a button to the right-hand side of that keyboard where it says next phase. Press that button.
Yes.
So what does the top line say now?
APPR.
Good. Okay, now I'm going to give you weather information, and to the left-hand side of that screen, you're going to have to type in the weather. With the local QNH, the air pressure is
1015.
Okay, use the top left button in the left-hand corner, upper left, to insert the QNH.
Okay.
Okay, because we're going to perform an Autoland landing, I need you to insert on the decision height, on the right-hand side of that display, I need you to insert no, November Oscar.
So I just used the letters. And then I put, okay, wait, N-O, and then?
Okay, if you have no inserted, then
yeah. Press,
there's a button next to the decision height, Delta Hotel, there's a little window, just press
yeah.
it in there.
Okay.
Okay, the next thing we'll be talking about, I need you to prepare yourself for your approach. I need you to figure out where all the buttons and switches and levers are, as I'm going to guide you down the ILS. You're still now within the holding, and we're gonna have to descend. I want you to descend to 5,000 feet.
I don't even know where it says how high we are. FCU.
It doesn't say FCU on it, but there's a long little display with numbers in it, and there's dials to use the autopilot.
I'm not sure what you're saying.
At the moment it says speed 230, heading 260, and the altitude 10,000 feet.
Oh, in the middle? Ah, okay, yes, I found it.
Turn to 5,000 feet below. There's a button below the altitude window. You see the altitude window saying 10,000 feet. Turn
yeah, that I got
to
that.
5,000.
Okay, I have that.
Okay, good, very good. Then press the button. Very good. The airplane is now going to be going into descent to 5,000 feet. It does that all automatically. Okay? Now, what I want you to do, we're still in the holding aim, you know, actually flying away from the airport. I want you to use the heading button, which is left to the altitude button. Left to the altitude button, is a heading button.
The one with the little blue
correct, there's a
thingy.
Little diamond on it.
Yes.
Okay, I want you to pull that.
Out.
Out. Okay, the airplane is now flying on its heading. Okay, I want you to turn it.
Something just beeped.
Turn it in the opposite. Just turn it to the right.
How far?
Until it says 080.
Until it says 080.
Keep on turning it till.
Ah, see, now it's 00. Ah, okay. Right. 080. Yeah, I have that.
Okay, next to that is the speed.
Yes.
I want you to dial that to speed 220.
Is it? I can turn it to the left, yeah?
Correct.
Yes?
No, I repeat, it's speed 220.
Oh, shit. Wait, I got that wrong. 220. Yes, okay, yeah, got that.
Okay, what we're going to do now, we're going to turn back to the airport and... now you're going to have to, if I say turn heading, you use the heading button. If I say use the speed and etc., okay? You don't need the altitude anymore. The altitude is fine. We're going to leave it as it is right now. One more thing, to the right, in that panel up there, it says autopilot AP1 and AP2.
Yes, here in the middle, yeah.
Okay, I want you to keep, just that you know, I'm going to say turn on AP2. I want you to just let you know you have to put not.
I know
now,
where it is. I know
where
it
later.
Is. Yes. Okay. Yeah.
Okay. And then to the right of that, there's a little button called approach mode. It's an approach boat button. It's to the right of that APPR.
Yes. Correct. Yeah. Okay, I found it.
For
yeah.
That, you're gonna have to press that button if I say so.
Okay.
Okay. Just to let you know, the airport is now to your right-hand side. You're not gonna be able to see it because of the weather at the moment. But it's to your right-hand side, so you're going to have to be turning to the right when I say to you, okay? Okay, Caroline, you've now reached a safe altitude of 5,000 feet. I want you now to activate the approach phase. If you go to the performance page again on the MCDU panel.
Yes.
Okay, the approach phase should be in green. So is it in green?
No, it's in white.
Okay, then go a phase back. Use the button to the left.
Yes.
Okay, and there should be a button now where it says activate approach phase.
Yes.
Okay, activate approach phase.
It says confirm approach phase now.
Okay, press that button.
Okay, now it's green.
Okay, good. Now the approach phase is active and I want you to press the speed button. We've been talking at the beginning.
Yeah.
I want you to press that.
Yes.
Okay, very good. Now take the heading button and turn it to the right, heading 170.
Oh, we're turning off to the right. 170.
Very good. Okay, the airplane is now turning. And now we're going to have to slow you down.
There's no numbers between the new speed.
Don't worry about that. The speed is now fully managed. You don't have to worry about the speed anymore. The autopilot and the auto thrust system are taking over with that.
Okay.
Okay, Caroline, turn the heading button to heading 240.
240. Yes.
Okay, Caroline, I need you now to press the approach mode button. Please press the approach mode button.
I don't know which one that is. Ah, this one. That one? The one underneath, under 5,000 to the right?
It's the button below the 5,000 to the right, correct approach.
Okay, that.
And now press the autopilot 2 button.
Okay, yes.
What does the speed say right now?
210. A little bit below 210.
Okay, set flaps 1.
Okay.
What does the speed say right now?
192.
Okay, then select flaps 2.
Yes, I have that. I can see the runway lights.
And the aircraft will slow down automatically if you have engaged the auto brake system.
Okay. Yes.
The auto brake system is the switch above the clock.
Yeah? There's low, mid, and max.
Then please press medium.
Yeah.
You have now intercepted the ILS glide slope and you're established on the localizer. Okay, now I want you now please to extend the gear. The gear lever is below the clock.
Okay.
Okay, above the clock there is a landing gear indication light. Do you see three little green arrows?
Yes, I do.
The landing gear is now fully extended and in its locked position. Okay, set flaps 3.
Okay.
And extend full flaps, please.
Yes.
Okay, very good, Caroline. I want you to read out what it says on the upper ECAM left to the clock. There's green writing left to the clock in the upper ECAM. I want you to read that out.
Cabin ready and LDG gear on. Signs on. SPLRS arm and flaps full.
Okay, is there anything in blue?
No.
Okay, then if the writing is all in green, you have landing no blue, so your landing checklist is now completed. And now I want you to put your hands onto the thrust levers, please.
One pad.
Pull them aft when I say so.
Okay.
Remember, the aircraft will come to an automatic stop. You don't have to press any brakes.
Five hundred. Four hundred. Three hundred. Two hundred.
One hundred.
50, 40, 30, 20, 10. Retard.
Okay, pull the levers back. And then put them into reverse as we spoke before. And keep them in that position. Okay, wait until the aircraft comes to a full stop. Okay, now set the parking brake. Pull and turn. And now put the thrust levers back to idle. Okay, and now disengage the autopilot. There's the button on the side stick. I want you to disengage that, to press the red button. Okay, and now I want you to shut down the engines 1 and 2. Below the thrust levers are two switches. It's pull and pull back. Lift up and back, that's it.
Okay guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. So we're out of the simulator now and I want to get a feedback from Caroline what she says if it's actually possible for a passenger to land a plane. So what do you think?
Well, I don't think it is possible for a passenger to land a plane. It's way too complex, it's so many switches, it's so difficult. And just from flying a simulator, I'm so done for. We had to concentrate so much. And I don't think that if a person would be in the situation that it's really an actual plane flying, they would not be able to get it done, basically.
Okay. I have to admit, what you don't see is actually behind the scenes. It took us a very long time to actually establish communications with Carolin, to actually get in contact with her, that she knows what button actually to press to communicate with me. And until that actually happened, that actually took like 20 minutes. So Carolin, I want to say thank you very much for your time today. It was a great pleasure. You did really good. But as you also stated yourself, it's absolutely not possible to do that as a passenger. So we're going to call it a wrap here. So see you next week. All the best. Your Captain Joe.